I need a worship. Me da was
your.
Is that what your heart is saying?
Me da was
just rewind the tape from January. Sing again. Me free mako memo. Mishanza aye.
SSA.
Go ahead and speak the language. Speak the heavenly language. Go ahead. Activate your spirit. Set your body and your soul on fire by speaking the language of the Spirit. Thank you, Lord Jesus. Thank you, Heavenly Father, for a time such as this. In Jesus' name, put your hands together for the Lord. Please be seated. I didn't know. Yeah, you can fix it back, push it back, and then take your seat. I didn't know about Mother's Day until I got to Cuba. And one of the books that we were studying had a story about 8th March, Dia de los Madres, Mother's Day. And that was how I got to know about Mother's Day, but it has become a very important part of our annual activity, because if mothers were not of such an importance, there wouldn't have been the need of the making of a help meet. In other words, without mothers, whatever vision a man has, he cannot meet it. Amen. And the easiest way to explain explain that is that it is Mother's Day, not Girls' Day, not Women's Day, but Mother's Day.
Eda no enche chemono enye emaywa eda ena enye ema eda keke na eye enanom eda na onde na wonim bibia fa ho ekosi se okoku ba memu na eda etoso nwotwe e wo match busumi mu na wo kan enwome bia efa sa dwumedie no ho ena wo hunu hia ehia se sada na otu esi honom na wo hunu sa beka ye dada abrabo ho afenu mu no enyina dwumedie di tintiman e wo oman no anase wiase nyina no ehu hia na se enanom ehu ehia anka ehu ehia nyame se obebbo ema se wo meye emema akwafo.
On a day such as this, I believe strongly that the message should be directed to women. I want to take this opportunity first of all to thank God for Eve, the first mother of all mothers. And further, I want to ask all mothers to please be upstanding. And please come forward.
Jesus.
All mothers, come forward. All mothers, please come forward.
Mami Fuina, any dear Emra anymore. Who bet to me a Koswabon Samama? Who bet to me a Koswabon Samama?
Now, the rest of us, shall we be upstanding and let us, with a joyful heart, celebrate this wonderful mothers.
Jesus.
As you do so,
Jesus.
You are on your way,
Jesus,
of becoming a mother.
Amen.
So that the presence of a mother in your life will make you a father.
Amen.
So please, let's celebrate the mothers here. And come on, let's do it. I want my mom to come stand here, the mother of
Bonsem Emma Yemano, Bonsem Emano, Bonsem
Emano, and also to Auntie Leticia, who happens to be my girlfriend when we were in elementary school. She is in Akachi as we speak. I want to wish the both of them a happy Mother's Day and all mothers who have played a very, very wonderful role in raising destiny and generation changers, movers and shakers. I got a message from mommy that there is a performance by somebody, so I'll give her the microphone to the spoken word. Is she in? Is the person in? So let's receive my daughter with a spoken word for women. It is for mothers, so you keep standing. You keep standing.
Sambi Ebeko Ama Emma Ina na we dikan edia mo any a drink ama yemami Gloria Emami Letitia and so Sabri or Akache. Yeti Arinisemwa or de Emma Emma.
Ago, ago, ago. Apostle Abraham Lamteke Inga. Ni men ken namen asafon nupaika asafon bi ken men feni ekpeshi ebiene ni fine min banye den omanye. I welcome you all. Achaumina Ajile Oshedu, Believers House of Worship International. Na mwenek bine, minsheg binye, minsheg bini, ejake ye, fe agbini. Nyawo papa, yo papa, namo ana, ejawa wa amu fitengeleo. She is wealth far more than rubies. Yeife, ayeko kenye nichimoin papa. Women, well done for the hard work. Benije chere kupule, nye tiyo shi nye ha nye shia bi aniye ni. Nye kane bo nyong, nye bilion nye da ye ni le mling. Ni mling hilemla, kanye lile ano. You speak with wisdom and faithful instructions are on your tongue. Oh, wulang alamte, mo ochuno, bo, mani ohejo, yeye atein, bo jikonti ni ashi ose ni amopo, bo, eka yo, okashi owo, oko owu, nyekashi nyewo, ninye ha Believers House of Worship International, ejo ke bashing mene, nye ha Believers, min pele tamongunami. Na, ye modem boloi, Heshikaloi, ngaloi kenile loi fe, wake nye bomodein. Ayoko kene nichumoi kbakba. Well done, bienve, wogda, bagba into. Ata, na anyomo, ajon ye fe, ye waladon.
Wow, wow, wow. Nyomo ajobo hu, ocho awo papa. Nioshele, ye Yesu baamu.
Amen.
I know next year we will have more mothers.
Amen.
The following year we will have more mothers.
Amen.
In the next 5 years, when it is Mother's Day, you will take over the whole place.
Amen.
In Jesus' name, we celebrate you and we wish you all a happy Mother's Day. Let's celebrate them again. God bless you. How many of you saw my mother? She was giving some old time moves. She reminded me when I was a young man, Jesus, the moves I used to give. Amen.
Amen.
Please be seated. I see my channels as well. If today is your first time of fellowshipping with us on a Sunday, can you give me a wiper? God bless you. God bless you. God bless you for coming. Jesus. This is Believers House of Worship International, where Jehovah dwells. Amen.
Amen.
And I believe one thing about God, that everywhere God is, there is life. Everywhere God is, there is hope. And everywhere God is, there is liberty. I want to open our eyes to the next series we will be treating from today till Gathering of Purpose
2021.
From 23rd of this month to the 30th of this month, Gathering of Purpose 2021 takes off.
Come
on, let's celebrate the glory of God.
Gathering of Purpose.
Our speakers are ready, they are poised, they are charged to be a blessing, not only unto us, but as many that will find their way here.
Amen.
Reverend Dr. Lawrence Tete will be coming here.
Jesus. Also, Penny Lawrence Tete.
Bishop Nibi Apiakai Takia Boy will also be here.
Jesus.
prophet Sam Addison will be here.
Jesus. Hallelujah.
Myself and you will be here.
Amen.
But above all, the greatest of all,
Jesus,
the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit will be here.
Jesus.
I want to encourage all of us that we get ourselves ready, we position ourselves strategically so we don't miss our train. Amen.
Amen.
And also after service, choir, protocol, technical, musicians, and which other group. After service, we will meet downstairs. We'll break bread for a successful act of worship. And then we will brainstorm and put some few things in place for gathering of purpose. So please, don't hurry home after service. And if you don't mind, you can join a group, any of the groups that I have mentioned, immediately, so you will be part of it after service. Choir, protocol, media, technical, sound, musicians, and pastors. And yes. And who else? Bible readers. I didn't see them here during Art of Worship. They came to church, but they were not at Art of Worship. That's why I didn't add deacons. But all the deacons that were here, you must be part of this. Amen.
Amen.
The Lord bless you. I have been praying to God for 2 days now. That's 3 days today and yesterday over some few things that I deemed necessary that the church should begin to look at.
Abo enoma bi ehun paye be na mienu ni esre nyame enoma bi a ehun hia safo no a ese itumi etwa yeni ehwe.
Because all of a sudden the mission of the church is being shifted to the wrong place.
Empofrumu a asori no eni suade hunu no echia ekwesi emfom ekwanzo.
And because of that we have lost our effect and impact in society. The church is no longer functioning according to the purpose of the mission of Christ. It's a mission for reconciliation. Or to give you a simple English, reconnection. Unfortunately, the church has become a center for disconnection. The church has become a center of separation. It has become a center of pain and hurt. It's supposed to be a place of healing. Unfortunately, it has become a place where people are made sick. It's supposed to be a place of refuge. Unfortunately, we have rather made the church vulnerable. And we give our own to the world whilst we protect the world. And I realize that we have become so because we have pushed the Spirit out of our lives, out of the church, out of everything we do as Christians. So the
the breath, the life wire of the church has been pushed out, and the church is there like an empty box. And if the church keeps pushing the spirit away, what we will end up becoming will be empty cymbals. We will be ineffective. We will be as useless as the letter U, and nothing good can come out of us, because the church cannot be built without the spirit.
So
then you will ask, what is the Spirit? What is the Holy Spirit? Some will say the Holy Spirit is the breath of God, is the life of God. The Holy Spirit is God. The Holy Spirit is the implementer, the one that brings into fulfillment and implementation every plan and purpose of God. But this morning, I want us to look at a story that took place in the Bible. That is in the New Testament. Then we will marry it with the Old Testament and see whether we are standing at the right place or we have chosen where we want to stand. In this story, Jesus decided to reveal God to a woman rejected by society because of her records. A woman rejected by the church, rejected by society, rejected by men, happened to be the one Jesus found qualified to reveal God's identity to that woman. And I know very well that there are many people walking in regret because of the way they related to some people in the past and who God has made out of those people today. And they wished they hadn't done what they did. We do so because we do not have the Spirit of God in us. Because if the Spirit is in you, you can see the tomorrow of a person. And that will determine how you relate. When you relate in the flesh, you regret by the flesh. But when you relate in the spirit, you rejoice by the Lord. We must come to the place of seeking the spirit, so we will know how to relate to each other. The Spirit of God is a revelator. The Spirit of God is an exposer. The Spirit of God is a light. So if you have the Spirit of God in you, definitely darkness never comes your way. And saying darkness, then I mean hatred. I mean unforgiveness. I mean bitterness and all the things that are associated with darkness. But if you have the Spirit of God inside you, you then expel the darkness and you walk in light. And because you walk in light, you exude love. You exude forgiveness. You exude care. You exude understanding. And at the end of the day, you walk in His glory.
As
believers, Christians, if I want to marry this new series to what we just finished, then I want to ask a question. If we have been colonized by God, do we still look like citizens?
So what the asan fufuru ya wobekan e bata dada na wewie no ho dia na se onyame na edi yeso a obisa se ye betumi aka se ye tese nyame ana.
John the chapter number 4,
Johannes 89,
the verse, if you start from verse 1 it will be okay, but I want us to cut a short story long, so go to verse 7.
Johannes 89 chichemu enson.
John chapter 4, verse 7. Then a woman from Samaria.
I can't hear her. John 4, 7. Please read again.
John 4, 7. Then a woman from Samaria.
A woman from where?
Samaria.
A woman from where?
Samaria.
Lizzie, a woman from where?
Believer's house of worship.
Good. Jesus. Continue.
Came to draw water. Jesus said to her, "Give me a drink." Verse 8. For his disciples had gone off into the city to buy food.
Wait. Let me work this place. Pardon. This woman came when there were no disciples around. Don't know a person in multitude. Somebody amongst may destroy the person to you.
Jesus.
I won't break it down. Never know a person in multitudes. Somebody may hate that person and destroy the person to you. Know a person on a personal note. Because hear me, what you may be hearing about the person may be coming from a hater. So this woman came when the disciples, you can imagine if Peter were there. He's a disciple, but not the discipler. So all of them left, and this woman came, and Jesus said, "Give me a drink." Now read the 8.
Verse 8. For his disciples had gone off into the city to buy food. Verse 9. The believer's house of worship woman asked him, "How is it that you, being a Jew, ask me, a Samaritan woman, for her drink?"
Nakai wafe Christo jamo. I'm talking about the spirit now. And what I'm treating now is a walk with the spirit. A walk with the spirit. This is how the church has become. If you don't belong to Roman, if you don't belong to Presby, if you don't belong to Shiaeno, if you don't belong to believers, if you are not a member of Action, if you don't belong to Royal House, if you don't belong to ICGC, if you don't belong to Lighthouse, then you don't deserve water. So Jesus, his mission was to break this thing. Unfortunately, we have brought it back. The very thing he came to dissolve is what we have pushed into the freezer to let it solidify again. The very thing he came to kill is what we are giving life again. The woman said, How is it that you, a member of Believers House of Worship International, you people, nye yusu akasha, Marrakesh, chaka cha cha cha, ayamonsuro, mensuro, minyi wunama ayamonsu, monsuro, aye, na menye wuname. You people, that is how you do your service. And we, where we come from, we speak to me, Lord Jesus, me need to hear from you. If you don't speak, Lord Jesus, me don't know what to do. Speak to me. It doesn't match up. It doesn't match up. You, a Jew, and me, a Samaritan, we don't drink from the same well. Excuse me, sir, we don't have Jewish Bible. We don't have Greek Bible. We don't have Jewish Christ. We don't have Greek Christ. We don't have Roman Jesus. We don't have believers Jesus. All we have is Jesus Christ. The Spirit is the same in Ghana. The Spirit is the same in Holland. The Spirit is the same in America. America. It is the custodian of the spirit who fails to see the spirit and walk with the spirit. The segregation and disintegration of the church is as a result of we fighting to give the spirit an identity instead of the spirit giving us. There is this old song I learned from Divine Healers. Christo webi nyefa po nyefa keya talena tahula ni yokuningle afile akekle tahula ni yokuningle afile ake. It didn't say believers' house of worship. Nyefa eke Christo. Will be Christo will be Christo for no Christo soon eke Roman soon eke apostolic soon. The greatest problem of the church is our inability to look through the spirit so we can look over denominational names. We don't see things through the eyes of the spirit. We see things through the eyes of the names on our churches. And ladies and gentlemen, the churches were there, yet Jesus started a new thing without a church name. You can't walk as a Christian. You can't walk with God and look outside the spirit. That's why for some time now, this song really keeps ministering to me about of Yao Sapon. Ladies and gentlemen, we must come to the place of realizing that the water we are all drinking does not belong to Ghana alone. It doesn't belong to America. It is a water for all of us. And if we will understand that it is the master who gives us the water, we will not call somebody unqualified. Look at your neighbor, ask the person, are we cool? Are we cool? Now let me show you something. Pick a chair from action. Right? Come and put it here. And let a member of this church sit on that chair. And see whether the chair will throw the person off.
And
you will see the inscription at the back of the chair. They've written Action Chapel. Yet, even when a fetish person sits on that chair, the chair will not throw the person away. Do you know the secret? Because the chair still stands strong in the purpose of its creation. The chair is never ready to change the reason why it was created. But we have changed the reason of our salvation. And we choose who to let sit and who to let fall. This woman had a question mark coming to her lifestyle, which I'll be getting there in a jiffy. I'm just introducing this series, A Walk with the Spirit, because the church is no longer interested in the things of the spirit. We are so much into things of the flesh. I wore this one last month. I don't think... Let me tell you something. When you come to my house, and those of you who have been here for long, you will see that I have some dresses I keep repeating and keep repeating. Not that I don't have new dresses, but ladies and gentlemen, I know what I feel when I wear that dress. I was telling you last Thursday when a pastor gave me a gift of a dress, a brand new dress. I was going to preach somewhere for the first time. Oh, don't miss coming Thursday. We're talking about the mystery of gifts. When I was going to preach at a place for the first time, I had 3 days program and I decided to wear this new dress given me by a pastor. Ladies and gentlemen, I disgraced myself at the program big time. I had fasted, I had prayed, I had prepared, I had a message from the Spirit, but I was wearing the wrong dress. And so when I went, I had the Bible, but the Bible doesn't have me. What I was wearing had separated me from my mission. How many of us claim to be Christians, yet we are wearing a different dress, the dress of hatred, the dress of bitterness, the dress of envy, and because of that, the Spirit cannot come in. The Spirit will come when you wear a dress, it can identify with her. You can't recall a military man if you are wearing a fire service uniform. Change the dress.
Santadia and Wood to me and your Renny, now won't share or do for Antadia. Natadia, your support be Edman or Manico Share.
I messed up.
If he said,
when I finished preaching, my son took me to his office and he said, Eja, minimo. He's a dangerous prophet. He said, Eja, Atadia no bidiche.
Nobody will be a friend or a bizarre, say, Atadia no.
I went to preach in his church. That was where I messed up the first day. Then he said, it was given to you by a pastor, right? I said, yeah. And he went ahead and told me, yeah, he did something to the dress before giving it to you. I know you. Yeah, don't use it again. The next day, I took a different dress that I know to the place. He came to the program. The Lord moved mightily. You know why? Because 2 Corinthians 5:17 says, therefore, if any man... So if you are in, then what you are in is wearing you. So now I am in. Ladies and gentlemen, we don't get what we want because we are out of who can provide. When I finished, he followed me to go see the pastor. And the guy said, please sit down. He made the other pastor sit and took me to the office. And then he said, Eja, so for not here, but you know, I said, yeah. Then he said, on no ma watadie nana. I said, yeah.
Jesus.
Then he said, Eja, onpe uye. Fortunately, he had another door. So we used the other door, entered my car, and I left.
Jesus.
3 days later, Sunday after service, that pastor called me. And that was when my anger came. And I said, you know what? Your dress is waiting for you. And if you don't come for it, I will bring it to your church and tell everybody what you did to the dress. Yes, I wouldn't do that. But I had to let him know that because I am in the Spirit.
Jesus.
The Spirit will let somebody see. You are not getting what I... Listen to me. Let us begin to walk in the Spirit. Yes, and the Spirit will direct people from far to come and protect the Spirit, take care of the Spirit, and deliver. Let me tell you something. The bank you have all your money in, you think about that bank 24/7. Am I right? So if God is in you, won't he think of you? If he is the Spirit and the Spirit is in you, he says, greater is he. Can you ask yourself, where is the Spirit? Just look on the inside and check where the Spirit is. Where is the Holy Spirit in your life? Because every second, in Jesus' name, so our focus is on Jesus. But then Jesus is gone to heaven and he has promised us the Holy Spirit. Jesus. And the Holy Spirit has come. Instead of having a relationship with the Holy Spirit, we bypass the Spirit and we are talking about Jesus. If you bypass the Spirit, Jesus will not hear you. Oh, you are not getting what I'm saying. And most of us... In the name of Jesus, and nothing happens. Why? Because there is a break between the Spirit and the Jesus we are calling. And when you break them, you can never get results. This woman has... Let's read. Continue, my daughter. Sorry.
Verse 10. Jesus answered her, if you knew about God's gift of eternal life...
If you knew
about God's gift. And what is the gift? Eternal life. What is eternal life? Life of joy. Life of peace. Life of happiness. No, let me use the simple word. Life of satisfaction. That whatever you have, you protect, you work, and then you love it. You are satisfied with it, but not unsatisfied. The eternal life is when you see God in everything you do and everything that happens to you. Eternal life is when even in the midst of pain, you still see God. In the midst of rejection, you still see God. In the midst of hatred and disappointment, you still see God. Vengeance is a product of inability to see God in a situation. But if you will see God in what the person is doing to you, you will know that they meant it for evil, but God meant it for good. Jeez. Because every evil act of the devil upon a believer is a strategic diversion that God will use to make a way for the believer. All things work together. You will need the Spirit to understand this. You sit in a car.
What's the shame?
You are traveling. You want to go somewhere. You want to do something. Then all of a sudden, you begin to feel like, don't go. Sometimes you hear an audible voice. How many of you have had that experience before? Sometimes it's a scare, some fear. Let me tell you something. Before this church was burnt, Uncle, if you will remember, I was going to Europe, and I called all the deacons and the pastors, and I told them, I feel there is some fear in me. I feel like I will crash in the air. I don't know, but I feel like something evil. The Holy Spirit was talking, and then the Monday, I was packing. I'm showing you walking with the Spirit. He prompts you because the Spirit is the same yesterday, the same today, and the same tomorrow. You get the prompting. And I told them, then the Monday when I was packing, I had a call that the church has been banned. Could it be what I was feeling? Yes, it is. The Spirit prompted me. There's a relationship. A blind spirit becomes a sheep about to be slaughtered at Mayanka, and that sheep will think it's at Trasaku. When your spirit is asleep, you look like a sheep at the slaughterhouse. And you rather see the slaughterhouse as airport residential area.
Jesus.
But the Spirit will open your eyes to see where you are and what they intend. When you have a relationship with the Spirit turns you into a spirit. So you see things and people will marvel. How did you know? How did you hear? Who told you? Nobody but the Supremo. What relationship? Now let me show you something. All these men, as we read, did not know their destiny. Mahadoja, Kabrande Bidiado Zataya. But when the woman came into contact with Jesus and she was restored and given the gift of revelation, she saw some gentlemen who could be used by God and their destinies will be established. You will destroy many if you don't have a relationship with the Spirit, because you cannot tell who they will be. Some of you will even kill your own house help. But if you have a spiritual eye and you are related to the Holy Spirit, you will see great woman in that house help.
Jesus.
Let me bring. Some of you hate some people with your breath. But if you are in relations with the Holy Spirit, you will get to a point of discovering that, hey, the person I hate is about becoming the next president.
So
hatred is not an approval of impossibility. The fact that you hate somebody does not mean you have sanctioned the person never to break through. Everybody in that town hated the woman, and you will discover the reason. Lizzie, continue. Continue. Today, I'm taking the scriptures one after the other, so I will lay a proper foundation. Listen to me. You cannot leave here and go to Cape Coast walking. You cannot leave here and get to your next place in destiny without the Holy Spirit, because that is the vehicle. The Spirit of God is the vehicle. Ladies and gentlemen, the louder the flesh, the more silent the spirit. Somebody say after me, Lord Jesus.
Lord Jesus.
This morning
I receive power
to silence
the flesh.
I say
to my ears,
my eyes,
my nose,
my lips,
my hands,
and
my feet.
Shut up. Continue, my daughter.
If you knew about God's gift of eternal life, and who it is who says, "Give me a drink," you would have asked him instead, and he would have given you living water.
You don't know. That's life. Why you are doing what you are doing. You just don't know. Ole.
Winim.
Ole. Look at your neighbor. Tell the person you don't know.
True, be say winim.
I can't hear you. Tell your neighbor you don't know.
Winim.
Jesus. Say it again. You don't know.
Winim.
My mom is sitting here. There were times they referred to me as the most useless. Don't fight them when they talk out of ignorance. Hold firm to the Spirit. And then when you get into where the Spirit is taking you, you will look back and say, they didn't know. They didn't know. They didn't know.
No one knew.
There's this old song. Seminya techa ma dedo. Midi botu yum dedo. Ayi meradi. Ayada. Aza ayamami. Mi re firido. Aminya miye. When you walk with the Spirit, there is a perpetuity of joy, even in pain. When you walk with the Spirit, even in your falling, you praise God. When you walk in the Spirit, you live a life of hope, because you know that the vision is for an appointed time, though it tarries. Jesus answered and said unto her, "If thou knowest the gift of God and who it is that saith to thee, 'Give me to drink,' thou wouldest have asked of him, and he would have given thee living water." Next verse.
She said to him, "Say, you have nothing to draw with, no bucket and rope, and the well is deep. Where then do you get that living water?"
Listen to me. When the Spirit is talking, you need to be in the Spirit to understand.
Jesus.
Mahado vazu teke branda. Mando lebede dukia dazata. Rade de de mado jahazabadanderia. Yukado le de de brandi mado vazo teke banda diada. Iabadada branda dibidia. All of a sudden the flesh becomes immune and you see things but you don't see. Sometimes you blow in tongues and as you cross the streets people will call you mad. But you are not where they are. The flesh always stays back, but the Spirit places you ahead.
Maminary soldier. If you reserve your job,
I'm in sense. If you reserve your job, I'm in the sense. So, red, so red,
the woman said unto him, "Sir, you have nothing to draw with, and the well is deep. From whence then hast thou that living water?" When people walk in the flesh, they will never believe the future you declare. Can I say it again? When people walk in the flesh, they will never believe in the future you declare. But when they walk in the spirit, they know that greater is what you are even declaring. Grante, when we started this place, you know, and we were entering the church from this place, and we'll descend in mats, but I did not see those days. And if you recall, those days when I'm preaching, everything you see today were things I said even when we were in the mat.
You're
not hearing what I'm saying. Why fight the person with eyes if you are blind? I don't think you are getting what I'm saying. Why fight the person with eyes if you are blind? Many stepped off because I sounded too big to my size. And when they look at themselves, they felt what I was saying was as a result of what I know they had. So they felt I was saying so depending on what they have. So they left with what they thought would have been what God needed to build. What they did not know was that they were rather blocking something greater.
Jeez.
Hear me. When the spirit is talking, you shut up if you are standing in the gutter.
Jeez.
When the spirit is talking, you shut up if you are not on the level. I have come to the place of realizing it is dangerous to kick your feet,
Jesus,
to the Holy Spirit. Everything I said, let me tell you something. That was during Woman Thou Art Loose. I took the microphone on the first day and I said, how I wish we had LED screen. You remember? I did not know where it was coming from. Then Pakwesi gifted us the light. So the day he brought the light, then I told him, how much will it cost to have this one here, because I'm not too okay with the big ones they do in the middle. It makes the stage, but I don't know about you. If you like it, contribute and buy that one. Hallelujah.
Jesus.
And I said it, but the Spirit has spoken. The Spirit will now bring it into fulfillment. Yuma, you were here. The day they were fixing the light, I was sitting here. Then I had a call. The person was like, Eja, you're talking about LED screens. How much will it cost? Then I said, oh, the gentleman who does it is here. So you talk to him. I stepped aside.
Jesus.
Oh, we will learn walking with the Spirit. I stepped aside
Jesus.
And released the two of them. I was there Today is Sunday, eh? Tuesday, Wednesday, then I had a message on my phone. Daddy, I have paid half.
Jesus.
We'll see what the Lord will do in 2 weeks. I'm like, Holy Ghost, you too, you can be too known, Papa. And then yesterday, I didn't know. Mommy called me and said, guess what? I said, what? She said, I won't tell you. I said, what? She said, I won't tell you. I said, look, what you don't like is what you are doing. I am a good man to repeat. What is it? She said, I won't tell you. Then Body took the phone. Jesus. I said, Dad, they are fixing barely the screen. I nearly dressed up to come here.
Jesus.
But yesterday has been one of the days my body decided to discipline me. One of my friends was asking me this morning if I could preach. I said, yes, I will. Ladies and gentlemen, I walked in this morning and what the Spirit said, to somebody, it is nothing. But to me, you are not getting what I'm saying.
Jesus.
To somebody, oh, and what is LED? But to me,
LED crying again.
Knowing it is the Lord,
when say,
I am grateful. People who walk in the Spirit walk with a handbag full of gratitude. You are not hearing what I'm saying. People who walk with the Spirit carry gratitude everywhere they go. You can imagine if we get the other one also. It's already there.
Amen.
People who walk in the Spirit, they see what the flesh don't see. So when they are doing business, they don't get scared. When things go down, they see it as an opportunity to leap up. People who walk in the Spirit believes in whatever they do with their hands. People who walk in the Spirit do not believe it when men cast them down. People who walk in the Spirit don't give up because they are tired. People who walk in the Spirit rely on God in everything they do. This woman rejected by society. I am coming to give you her CV. Verse 12. My time is up, right? Verse 12. Let's read it. Are you greater than our father who? Jacob. Who gave us the well and drank thereof himself and his children and his cattle? Next verse. Jesus answered and said unto her, whosoever drinketh of the water of the flesh, whosoever relieth on words of men, whosoever relieth on provisions of men, whosoever relieth on association of men, oh, because of who you know, because of the great, oh, do you know me? I know people in high places. After their death, go to that same high place and see if you will matter. Jesus. A simple example. Jesus. There were people who mattered under Rawlings, but they didn't matter under Kufuor. There were people who mattered under Kufuor, but didn't matter under Tamils. In fact, the better example is Tamils and Jomama of the same party. People who mattered under Tamils didn't matter under Jomama. I believe that also contributed in some tensions. And people who mattered under Jomama didn't matter under Nanado. In fact, some people who mattered under Nanado's first term, this second term, introduction of second term,
Jesus,
we have not even heard their names. Keep relying on men. But they that put their trust in the Lord, they that put their trust in the Lord, they may look weak, but they will still stand. They may look hungry, but they will still stand. They may look poor, but they will still stand. Beloved, this morning, I want to introduce the Holy Spirit unto you. It is not by race. It is not a competition. Hold on to the Holy Spirit. The woman said unto him, sir, You have not. Give me verse 12. Verse 12.
Are you greater than our father Jacob?
Listen, some people are insulting you because they don't know you.
Hello.
What is? Can I say this? If you know you are working with the Holy Spirit, don't introduce yourself. Let the Holy Spirit do the introduction. Did you hear me? You don't need to announce who you are. Can I say it again? Ladies and gentlemen, Art of Worship last Sunday, how many of you were here? How was it? How was last Sunday's Art of Worship? We have had Art of Worship on several occasions. Now, last Sunday's program, we didn't do too much advert. It was only Atinka and then Facebook. That's all. This place was full. We went for extra chairs. We rented extra chairs. But the school, I had only four students. The first day, two came. Second day, four. Third day, two. Meanwhile, I had invested what they will eat at lunch, their certificates, and also the members of faculty, the lecturers and things, had to take care of all of them. And only four students came. Ladies and gentlemen, don't you think it is a recipe for disaster? It is enough for me to say then the program itself is a mess. And as at the Saturday, I was so down. But strangely, after 5, 6, 7 thereabout, I felt some sharpness in my spirit, Jesus. Like a prompting by the Holy Spirit. Jesus. Then I began to vajaza dobreke, andimado jahakabaya, rondikibaya. Let me tell you something. We don't fight flesh. And because it's a spirit, you can't see what you are fighting. But if you are in the spirit, you see them for the weapons of our warfare.
Jesus.
Ask your neighbor, who are you working with? No, do it well. Ask your neighbor, as a Christian, who are you working with? Then came the Sunday. The program was to start at 4. By 3:30, people were coming. By 4:30, the place was half full. By 5, I was panicking. If the Spirit says it, by 6:30, the place was on fire. By 7, we had taken off. By 8, we have obtained our altitude. By 8:30, we were landing in the heavenlies. Who say man no day? You can break me, but I know who I'm working with. You can crush me, but I know who I'm working with. You can envy me, but I know who I'm working with. Let us walk with the Spirit.
Thou art welcome, Holy Spirit. Thou art welcome.
Look at something next. Continue, my daughter. I'm enjoying a walk with the Holy Spirit.
Who gave us the well? Who used to drink from it himself and his sons and his cattle also? Jesus answered her, everyone who drinks this water will be thirsty again.
Continue.
But whoever drinks the water that I give him will never be thirsty again.
Can you give me just 10 seconds to prophesy?
Jesus.
With the oil on my head, Jesus. I prophesy over your life.
Jesus.
Anything that made you thirst,
Jesus.
From today,
Jesus.
May the Holy Spirit satisfy you.
Jesus.
May the Holy Spirit satisfy you.
Jesus.
Are you thirsty for love? Are you thirsty for financial
Jesus.
Breakthrough? Are you thirsty for healing?
Jesus.
Are you thirsty for joy?
Jesus.
Are you thirsty for the fruits
Jesus.
Of the womb? Whatever the enemy has made you thirst in, today, by fire, by thunder, may the Holy Spirit quench that thirst.
Amen.
In Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
I thought you were slapping those hands
Jesus.
Onto the Lord. You will not thirst again. My mom has an old song she sings. Nuncho hami wala nule kumanu koni kuma akaye mito. Bo moni wala isu tenhuo ye umling hami eku manu. Nuncho, I like the chorus. Ami eko manu, manu eko nuncho. Bo moni wala insu tenhuo ye umling. Ami eko manu nuncho. All we need is a breath of the Spirit. For when that little girl, Talita, was dead, she wasn't dead.
Talita,
the spirit has been taken out. So when the spirit came, Talita, take back the spirit. Anything of yours that looks dead. Anything around you that looks dead. Anything within you that looks dead. Anything in your hands that looks dead. Anything in your heart that looks dead. As you reconnect with the Holy Spirit, let it come back alive.
Amen.
Let it come back alive.
Amen.
Let it come back alive.
Amen.
If they buried him and he still came back,
Jesus,
then there is something about the Spirit.
Jesus.
Place your two hands on your chest and say, Holy Spirit, introduce me to yourself. Come on, say it well. Say, Holy Spirit, introduce me to yourself. Holy Spirit, reconnect me. Reconnect me. Reconnect me.
Jesus.
Verse 15.
The woman said to him, "Say, give me this water."
Ke onu Yehowa juemo kafenten hemonio mi ye mi no nu no shwe no kafenten ake wonu anhu wetowo. Utinyamia samua and yet genia homasuo mini huan kamedia who prepredia samono Marie Amene and Monsieur Gusso because a young pan.
Amen.
When she heard, she said, "Give me this water.
Oti yen wokan sa mam sensu ibi
that I thirst no more."
Sebe yes come and mibi.
Etole.
No abre.
Etole.
Wabre.
Bros, you know tire. Yesterday, my son, I don't know how many of you saw it on his status. My son, Jasper, he put a friend's house on his status. Jesus Christ. Somebody say Jesus.
Jesus.
Who say money no sweet? He has his own bathroom, but aside the bathroom, there is a swimming pool. And a 7-in-1 jacuzzi.
Jeez.
Oh, wait now. Just close to the 7-in-1 jacuzzi, he has his winery. The cheapest wine, £500. And he has about 200 wine in there. Oh, wait, wait. Then when you climb, you come to the gym. And as for the gym, everything there is gold plated. A chair that when you sit in, it will check your weight before it will calculate the kind of massage you need. A chair. And that chair, he has about three. And the one doing the video says, "Sha, bros, you know how to bluff money.
Jeez.
Ah, this man, you despoil money."
Jeez.
Then he took the phone from the guy and said, "Now you sit in the chair and enjoy some."
Mm.
Are you not tired?
So I'm ready.
Those enjoying that way, were they born different?
Jesus.
Amen.
Jesus.
Heni ame choke ba. Jeje no wofe pu waje kuye.
Jesus.
Alo leke Google first je kuwe funi bi. Ha. You know tire. Bros, you know tire. And then they climbed up. He just showed three places to the theater.
Baby, me and
oh, gosh. A theater for just 11 people. And yeah, each chair in the theater. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Oh, no. Oh,
oh, he could say, fair fleck, therefore, what? But hear me. The Holy Spirit will let you understand that it is not of him that willeth, nor of him that runneth. It's just a matter of time. When you see a story building, yeah, we have the first floor, we have the second floor, but all of them are standing on the ground floor. Every debt is dropped there, but that is the sustainer. My darling, you can never understand your walk with the Spirit until you become happy to yourself.
Jesus.
She said, give me this water that I thirst not. Neither come hither. Oh, Jesus. This woman, I don't want to be thirsty, and I don't want to be found in this category of people again. How many of you want a change? Oh, come on. You want a change. Locate the Holy Spirit, and the Holy Spirit will put a stop. It's a matter of decision. Continue. 16.
And this, Jesus said, go, call your husband and come.
Oh, I feel like preaching now, Jesus. But my time is up. Hadabo Shabaya. Anytime you are willing to accept the Spirit, he will delete your past. Can I preach this? The Spirit cannot walk with you whilst you are carrying the past. He will take care of it. And so when he puts goodness and mercies behind you, it's because he has left your past not to be carried along. Please help me sing. You know I'm a good singer, but if I am not able to, you should know. Set me free now. Set me free. Do I have a worshiper here? Many ringwa. You Lord. Let's look at the turning point and I'll close. Jesus said unto her, go, call thy husband and come here. The woman answered and said, I
do not have a husband.
Continue.
Jesus said to her,